Now we are going to start the new chapter, which is quadrilaterals. So here, what is the meaning of the quadrilateral? The name itself says is here. Quadrilateral is nothing but the four, and the lateral is nothing but the sides. So what is meant by the quadrilateral? It draws a figure that consists of four sides. We call it as a quadrilateral. That means if you consider any four points on a plane, if you draw it here, you will get a quadrilateral. So consider here one point, one point, one point, and one point. So here, if you join it here, you will get here the four sided figure. We call this one as a quadrilateral. So what is meant by a quadrilateral? It draws a figure that consists of four sides. We call it as a quadrilateral. Now here, mark these points here: A, B, C, D. So in a quadrilateral, how many angles will be there? How many sides will be there? And how many right angles will be there? Let us see it here. You can observe here. This is one angle, and this is one angle. This is one angle, and this is one angle. What is meant by the angle? That means if you take any two rays, if these two rays will join at one point, here you can observe that this is not an angle because here these two points are not joined. So if these two lines will join at one point, here one angle will be formed. Similarly, here these two lines are joined at this common point. We call this common point as a vertex. So here one angle will be there. Here also these two lines are joined. Here angle will be formed. And similarly, here the remaining. So here, how many angles are there in a quadrilateral? There are four angles. What are those? Which is nothing but angle A. You can represent angle by the symbol angle A, angle B, angle C, and angle D. We can write this angle A in other two ways. How you can write this one? You can write it as DAB, or you can write it as BAB. By anything is the same, which represents the angle A. Just here, you need to check it here. Angle A should be in the middle, which represents that we are talking about the angle A. So here, you can write this one as angle DAB. Similarly, you can write it as DAD, or you can write it as angle A. Anything you can write it, which represents the angle A. Similarly, how do you write angle B? Just you need to check. You have to get this one in the middle. So you can write it as CBA, or you can write it as ABC. Anything you can write it here, you can write it as CBA, or you can write it as ABC. Similarly here, if you see angle C, what you can write it here, you can write it as DCB, or you can write it as BCD. Anything is same. And for D also, you can write it as ABC or CDE. This is about the angles. Now see the sides. So in a quadrilateral, how many sides are there? You can see it here: AB, BC, CD, and AD. So how many sides are there? Which is AB, BC, CD, and AD. Here you can observe that these are the line segment because it is having two endpoints here. Since if two endpoints are joined by the line segment, you know that a line segment will be formed. So you can represent those line segments here like this. It indicates that we are talking about the line segments. So how many line segments will be there in a quadrilateral? There are four line segments. What are those? It is AB, BC, CD, and AD. Now talk about the diagonals. So before talking about the diagonals, what is meant by diagonal? Diagonal is nothing but if you join the line segment that is formed by joining the opposite vertices, we call it as a diagonal. That means here, you know that this is a vertex. What is the opposite vertex? But this vertex. Now join the line segment here. So this will be one diagonal, and similarly here join the opposite vertex. Here you will get one more diagonal. So what is meant by the diagonal? The line segment that is formed by joining the opposite vertices, we call it as a diagonal. So how many diagonals will be there in a quadrilateral? There are two diagonals. What are those? Which is BD and here which is AC. These are the line segments to represent like this. This is about the quadrilateral. So what is meant by a quadrilateral? A closed figure that consists of four sides, we call it as a quadrilateral. In a quadrilateral, there will be four angles, and there will be four sides, and there will be two diagonals. Now, see about the sum of the angles of the quadrilateral. You already know that the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180. You already studied in the previous classes. So here, let us draw the quadrilateral now. This is a quadrilateral. Mark it as A, B, C. Now, draw one diagonal. here. And here mark the angles. Let us mark this angle as 1 and this angle as 2. Similarly here, this angle as 3 and this angle as 4. Now here you can observe that if you draw a diagonal, here you can observe that there will be two triangles are formed. And you know that the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180. Based on that, we are solving about the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral. What is the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral? Now we are going to prove that one. Now here, consider this triangle, the above triangle, which is triangle ABC. You know that the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180. Which triangle we choose here? We choose this triangle, the above triangle, which is B, here C, and here D. This triangle, the above triangle. So here, what is the angle here, which is angle 1, and here which is angle 3, and here which is angle D. So you know that the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180, and here you can write it here, angle D plus angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to 180. So write it here, in triangle ABC, how you can write angle D plus angle 1 plus angle 3 is equal to 180. Similarly, consider now the below triangle. So here, if you see the below triangle, what you get here, since the sum of the angles of a triangle is 180, this is the below triangle. This is C, A and B. What are the angles? Angle 2 and angle 4. Now, similarly, if you consider the triangle, in triangle ABC, you know that sum of the angles of a triangle is 180. You can write it as here, angle 2 plus angle 4 plus angle 3 is equal to 180. So write it here, angle 2 plus angle 4 plus angle 3 is equal to 180. Now, since we want to find the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral here, you need to get angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D. So, if you add these two triangles, here you can observe that if you add the sum of the angles of this triangle and sum of the angles of this triangle, you will get the sum of the angles of this quadrilateral just by adding these two. So here, just for that, you need to add these two equations. So here, by adding two equations, you need to check here, you need to add the left side part and you need to add the right side part separately. So here, adding these two equations, first write this one, angle D plus angle 1 plus angle 3. Here, what is the LHS? This one, which is angle 2 plus angle 4 plus angle 3. Now, we have written the LHS part, now add the RHS part, which is 180 plus 180. So here, write here angle D, and here what is left out, which is angle B. Now here, in case of angle 1 plus angle 2, what we can write it here, see it in the quadrilateral, angle 1 plus angle 2. This is angle 1 and this is angle 2. If you add angle 1 plus angle 2, you will get this angle, the total angle, which is angle A. So in place of angle 1 plus angle 2, you can write this total angle, which is angle A. So we have written, in place of angle A plus angle 1 plus angle 2, I have written angle A. Now, what is the left out here, which is angle 3 plus angle 4. Now check it here, what is angle 3 plus angle 4? This is angle 3 and this is angle 4. If you add, you will get here the total angle, which is angle C. So write it here, which is angle C. What is the value of 180 plus 180? You know that it is 360. Now write it in the proper order. So write it here, angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D, which gives you here 360. So what is the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral? Which is 360. Based on the sum of the angles of a triangle, we have proved this one. This is about the sum of the angles of a quadrilateral. Now see here, the next one, which is the properties of the quadrilaterals, or different types of quadrilaterals. Before that, draw some quadrilaterals here. So, because it consists of four sides. Here you can observe that 1, 2, 3, 4. Similarly here 1, 2, 3, 4 and here 1, 2, 3, 4. These are all the quadrilaterals. But you can observe that in all these three figures there is one similarity. What is the similarity here? You can observe that here this line is parallel to this line, right? And similarly in this one, this line is parallel to this line. And in this one, this line is parallel to this one. So here, based on that, we will get one type of quadrilateral which has a one name, that we call it as an trapezium. What we call that word? We call it as a trapezium. So how you can define the trapezium? In a quadrilateral, one pair of sides are parallel, we call it as a quadrilateral. Here you can observe that this is one pair and this is the other pair. Pair is nothing but two. So here you can observe that in a trapezium, one pair of sides are parallel. So what is meant by the trapezium? If one pair of sides are parallel in a quadrilateral, then we call it as an that one is trapezium. Now see here, these are the examples of the trapezium. So there is one special case in the trapezium. Let us observe that one. Here, if you consider this trapezium, you know that it is a trapezium because here one pair of sides are parallel. And here the non-parallel sides, you know that these are the non-parallel sides. Here these non-parallel sides are not equal in length. That means here let us consider this length is some. Let us consider this length is some 3 and let us consider this length some length is 4. So here you can observe that here the lengths are not same. So it is a trapezium, but here if you consider this case, this is also a trapezium because here one pair of sides are parallel. And if you see the non-parallel sides, what are the non-parallel sides here? These are the non-parallel sides and these non-parallel sides are equal in length. If this is 3 cm, clearly you can observe that this is also 3 cm. So this type of trapezium has a special name. This one we call it as an isosceles trapezium. So what is meant by a trapezium? In a quadrilateral, one pair of sides are parallel, then we call it as a trapezium. And if in a trapezium, non-parallel sides are equal in length, we got a special case that we call it as an isosceles trapezium. This is one type of quadrilateral. So here, the next one we are going to discuss the next type of quadrilateral. Here we are going to discuss about the 6 types. This is the first type. Now see the next one here. For this one, we call this one as trapezium. Okay, what is the difference between these two? Here you can observe that here, similarly it is also a trapezium because here one pair of sides are parallel. Here this line is parallel to this side. And you can observe that these are the non-parallel sides. And clearly you can observe that these are also parallel sides. That means here, in a trapezium, one pair of sides are parallel. And in a parallelogram, this one we call it as a parallelogram. So here, if in a quadrilateral, one pair of sides are parallel, we get a trapezium. And if two pairs of sides are parallel, we got a parallelogram. In a parallelogram, this line is parallel to this line, and this line is parallel to this line. So what we can say in a parallelogram, two pair of sides are parallel. That one we call it as an parallelogram. So we have discussed up to two types of the quadrilateral. These are what? Which is nothing but the types of quadrilateral. And see the next one here, which is, so we have talked about now trapezium and the parallelogram. See the next type of the quadrilateral here. So here if you observe this one, what is the difference between these two? Here you know that it is also a parallelogram because here this side is parallel to this side and similarly here this side is parallel to this side. meaning of rect is nothing but right. Right angle we call it as a rectangle. So what is a rectangle? That means you can say that every parallelogram is a rectangle, because here you can observe here two sides are parallel, here also two sides are parallel. Similarly here these two sides are parallel, these two sides are parallel. But here what is the extra condition? Here one angle should be the right angle. So this one we call it as a rectangle. Now we have discussed about the three types. See the next one, which is the
properties of these types of quadrilaterals. From this discussion is complete.